Hi friends, welcome back to My Government Track channel. And today in this video we'll discuss some important objective questions on measurement and instrumentation. So this topic comes under electrical branch and this will be useful for Mahadiscom JEE as well as BMC junior engineer exam. And this will be useful for mechanical students also, means they can refer this video for the preparation of BMC JEE. So we'll start without wasting much time with the first question of measurement and instrumentation. The first question is, the use of which instruments is merely confined within the laboratories as standardizing instruments? So which instrument will use for standardizing other instruments? So the correct answer for this question is option A, absolute. The use of absolute instruments is merely confined within laboratories as standardizing instruments. Next question, question number two, which of the following instruments indicate the instantaneous value of the electrical quantity being measured at the time at which it is being measured? So which of the following instrument? Correct answer is option B, indicating instrument. So indicating instruments indicate the instantaneous value of the electrical quantity being measured at the time at which it is being measured. Correct answer is option B, indicating instruments. Next question, question number three. Which instruments are those which measure the total quantity of electricity delivered in a particular time? Correct answer for this question is option D, integrating instrument. So that instruments is called as integrating instrument, which measures the total quantity of electricity delivered in a particular time. Next question, question number four. Which of the following are integrating instruments? Options are option A, ammeters, option B, voltmeters, option C, wattmeter, option D, ampere hour and watt hour meters. Correct answer for this is ampere hour and watt hour meter. So these are integrating instruments, the examples of integrating instruments. Question number fifth. Resistance can be measured with the help of what? Correct answer is ohmmeter and resistance bridges. So by using these two instruments, we can measure the resistance by using ohmmeter and resistance bridges. The correct answer is option D. Next question, question number six. According to the application, instruments are classified as what? The correct answer for this is option C, that is switchboard and portable. According to the application, instruments are classified as first is switchboard and the second is portable instruments. Next question, question number seven. Which of the following essential features is possessed by an indicating instrument? Options are deflecting device, controlling device, damping device, or all of the above. So these all three devices, that is deflecting device, controlling device and damping device, this essential features is possessed by an indicating instrument. So this feature should be present in the indicating instruments. Correct answer is all of the above. Question number 8. A dash device prevents the oscillations of the moving system and enable the latter to reach its final position quickly. Which device? So options are deflecting device, controlling device or damping device. The correct answer is damping device. So the damping device prevents the oscillation of the moving system and enables the latter to reach its final position quickly. Correct answer is option C, damping. Question number 9. The spring material used in the spring control device should have following property. What should be the property present in the spring material which is used in the spring control device? So properties are option A, should be non-magnetic. Yes, it's correct. It must be of low temperature coefficient. Yes, it should have low specific resistance. It should not be subjected to fatigue. The correct answer is option E, all of the above. So these properties should be present in the spring material which is used in the spring control device. That is, it should be non-magnetic, it should have low temperature coefficient, it should be low specific resistance, and it should not be subjected to fatigue. Next question, question number 10. Which of the following properties a damping oil must possess? So damping oil, it should be a good insulator first. It should be non-evaporating. It should not have corrosive action upon metal on the vane. And option D is the viscosity of the oil should not be changed with the temperature. So these four properties should be possessed by the damping oil. Correct answer for this question is option E. Next question, question number 11. A moving coil permanent magnet instrument can be used as dash by using a low resistance shunt. So that a moving coil permanent magnet instrument can be used as an ammeter by using a low resistance shunt. The correct answer is option A, ammeter. Question number 12. A moving coil permanent magnet instrument can be used as a flux meter by using what? So it can be used as a flux meter by using and eliminating the by eliminating the control springs. So by eliminating the control springs, a moving coil permanent magnet instrument can be used as a flux meter, and it can be used as an ammeter by using what? Low resistance shunt. Question number 13. Which of the following devices may be used for extending the range of the instruments? Which of the following devices is used for extending the range of instruments? The options are option A, shunt; option B, multipliers; option C, current transformers; option D, potential transformers. The correct answer for this question is option E, all of the above. That is, shunt, multipliers, current transformers, potential transformers are the devices may be used for extending the range of instruments. Next question, question number 14. An induction meter can handle the current up to what range, or what is the value of the current that induction meter can handle? Correct answer is 100 ampere. So 100 ampere current, it can be handled by the induction meter. D is the correct answer. Question number 15. For handling greater currents, induction wattmeter are used in conjunction with what? For handling greater currents, induction wattmeters are used in conjunction with current transformer, CT. Option B will be your right answer. Next question, question number 16. Induction type single phase energy meter measures electric energy in what? Induction type single phase energy meter, it measures the electric energy in KWS, that is kilowatt hour. So induction type single phase energy meter measures the electric energy in kilowatt hour. Option C is the right answer. Question number 17. Most common form of AC meter met with in everyday domestic and industrial installations are what? So correct answer is induction type single phase energy meters. So induction type single phase energy meters is the most common form of AC meters met with everyday domestic and industrial installations. Next question, question number 18. Which of the following meters are not used on DC circuits? Options are mercury motor meters, commutator motor meters, induction meter, and none of the above. So which of the following meters are not used on DC circuits? Correct answer is option C, induction meter. So induction meters are not used on DC circuit. Next question number 19. Which of the following is an essential part of a motor meter? So operating torque system, braking device, and revolution registering device. So these three are the essential part of a motor meter. Correct answer for this question is option D, all of the above. So these are the essential parts of the motor meter. Question number 20. Potentiometer may be used for what? Potentiometer may be used for measurement of resistance. Yes, correct. Measurement of current, calibration of ammeter, and calibration of voltmeter. So these are the uses of the potentiometer that can be used for measurement of resistance, current, calibration of ammeter, and voltmeter. Correct answer is option E, all of the above. Next question, question number 21. Which is an instrument which measures the insulation resistance of an electric circuit relative to earth and one another? So which instrument? That is Megger. So the Megger is the name of the instrument which measures the insulation resistance of electric circuit relative to earth and one another. B is the correct answer. Question number 22. Household energy meter is what type of instrument? So household energy meter is an integrating instrument. Option C will be the right answer for this question, integrating instrument. Next question, question number 23. The pointer of an indicating instrument should be what? The pointer of an indicating instrument should be very light. Option A is the right answer. It should be very light. The chemical effect of the current is used in what? Chemical effect of the current is used in DC ammeter hour meter. Option A, that is DC ammeter hour meter. So in that, chemical effect of current is used. Question number 25. In majority of instruments, damping is provided by what? So that damping is provided by eddy currents in majority of the instruments. Okay, option C is the right answer. Next question, question number 26. An ammeter is a what? Ammeter is a secondary instrument, absolute instrument, recording instrument, or integrating instrument. So ammeter is a secondary instrument. Option A is the right answer. Ammeter is a secondary instrument. Question number 27. In a portable instrument, the controlling torque is provided by what? Options are spring, gravity, eddy currents, all of the above. So in portable instruments, the controlling torque is provided by springs. Option A, spring is the right answer. Next question, question number 28. Question number 28, the disc of an instrument using eddy currents damping should be of what? The disc of an instrument using eddy current damping should be of conducting and non-magnetic material. So that disc is of conducting and non-magnetic material. Option C is the right answer. Next question, question number 29. The switchboard instruments, what? It should be mounted in vertical position or horizontal position. The switchboard instruments, it should be mounted in a vertical position. Option A, that is, should be mounted in a vertical position, is the correct answer. Question number 30. The function of a shunt in an ammeter is to what? The function of shunt in an ammeter is to bypass the current. What is the function of shunt? So it's to bypass the current in an ammeter. Next question. Question number 31. The multiplier and the meter coil in a voltmeter are. The multiplier and the meter coil in a voltmeter are in series. So those multiplier and meter coil are in series in a voltmeter. Option A is the right answer. Question number 32. A moving iron instrument can be used for what? Options are. Option A, DC only, AC only, or both DC and AC. So a moving iron instrument can be used for both DC as well as AC. C will be the correct answer. Next question, question number 33. The scale of a rectifier instrument is. The scale of a rectifier instrument is linear. Okay, option A is the right answer. It's a linear scale. Question number 34. For measuring current at high frequencies, we should use which instrument? For measuring current at high frequency, we should use thermocouple instrument. Option C, that is thermocouple instrument. Next question, question number 35. The resistance in the circuit of moving coil of a dynamometer wattmeter should be what? The resistance in the circuit of the moving coil of a dynamometer wattmeter should be high. Option C, it is high. Correct answer is option C. Next question, question number 36. A dynamometer wattmeter can be used for what? Dynamometer wattmeter can be used for both AC as well as DC. Option A will be the right answer. Next question, question number 37. An induction wattmeter can be used for what? An induction wattmeter can be used for DC only. Option B, that is DC, is the right answer. Next question, question number 38. The pressure coil of a wattmeter should be connected on the supply side of the current coil when what? So the pressure coil of a wattmeter should be connected on the supply side of the current coil when the load impedance is high. Option A, that is load impedance is the high. At that time, the pressure coil of a wattmeter should be connected on the supply side of the current. Next question, question number 39. In a low power factor wattmeter, the pressure coil is connected to the load side of the current coil. Okay, option B is the right answer. In the low power factor wattmeter, the pressure coil is connected to the load side of a current coil. Next question, question number 40. In a low power factor wattmeter, the compensating coil is connected in series with the pressure coil. Okay, the compensating coil should be connected in series with the pressure coil in what? In a low power factor wattmeter. Option C is the right answer. Next question. In a three-phase power measurement by two wattmeter method, both the wattmeter had identical readings. The power factor of the load was what? So if the power factor of the load is unity, then the both wattmeter had identical readings. Next question, question number 42. In a three-phase power measurement by two wattmeter method, the reading of one of the wattmeter was 0. The power factor of the load must be 0.5. When the power factor of the load must be 0.5, when the power factor of the load is 0.5, then one of the reading of one wattmeter is 0. Okay, option B is the right answer. Question number 43. The adjustment of the position of a shading bands in an energy meter is done to provide friction compensation. The correct answer is option A, friction compensation. The adjustment of the position of a shading bands in an energy meter is done to provide the friction compensation. Question number 44. An ohmmeter is which instrument? Options are moving iron instrument, moving coil instrument, dynamometer instrument, or none of the above. So ohmmeter is a moving coil instrument. Option B will be the right answer. Next question, question number 45. When a capacitor was connected to the terminal of ohmmeter, the pointer indicated low resistance initially and then slowly came to infinity position. So this shows that the capacitor is, options are short circuited, option B all right, option C faulty. So that capacitor is all right. Option B is the correct answer. Next question, question number 46. For measuring a very high resistance, we should use megger. Megger is the instrument to measure the very high resistance. Next question, question number 47. The electrical power to megger is provided by what? The electrical power to the megger is provided by permanent magnet DC generator. Okay, correct answer is option B. So by using the permanent magnet DC generator, the power is provided to the megger. Next question, question number 48. In a megger, controlling torque is provided by what? In megger, the controlling torque is provided by the coil. Option C is the right answer. Next question number 49. The operating voltage of megger is about what volt? 6 volt, 12 volt, 40 volt, 100 volt. So the operating voltage of a megger is about 100 volt. Next question, question number 50. Murray loop test can be used for location of what? So Murray loop test can be used for the location of both ground fault and the short circuit fault. C will be the correct answer. So the Murray loop test can be used for the location of both the ground faults and short circuit faults. So friends, these are the 50 questions which I have covered from the topic of measurement and instrumentation. Comes under electrical branch. So this video will be useful for mechanical students also, means they can refer for the BMC JE 2019 exam. The notification will come soon for BMC JE, and means they will start the application fill up link as well. So we'll discuss more questions and in the more topics as a part of electrical as well as mechanical. So stay tuned to My Government Track channel, and subscribe to My Government Track channel and press the bell icon so that you will get latest updates and this type of study materials daily. Okay, thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you.